DGS, if you go to statistics, is the Dagos on board. So all these are DG cargo on board. So this net weight, normally in most of the companies the planners are inputting net weight, but in some companies you will have to input this weight from the manifest. So how to input the weight? So like this cargo is there, if you double click this one, you see UN number is this one, IMDG class this one. So net weight you can put here. Let's say if the net weight of the cargo is 20,000, I'll push 20,000. Flash point is 15 degree, anything. And if it is a marine pollutant or not, you can check from here, marine pollutant, and just press OK. You see it will get highlighted here. This is the marine pollutant, packing group, weight, this is the net weight. So this all the informations you can put from the manifest. Okay, let's say you're loading almost 50 DGs in this port, and they're already 150 DGs from before, and like then it's you want to just want the DGs cargo only from this port. From this one also you can just filter from here, so you can just put your current port, like okay, I'm port afloat China, I'll put Nansha, and the filter you can put here is port afloat. Okay, you see now only the containers which are loading in Nansha are getting highlighted. So for me it's easy to check how many containers are loading here and how many this manifest have to input. So anything, just highlight here, put the net weight as I told you, gross weight, this flash point, and check for marine pollutant here. You can update here. So there's another way to input the weights in the DG container. Let's say okay, I'll show you one more thing. Any container you highlight, this tab is there on the right side. You can see the details of this unit. For the weight of this unit is 16 tons, serial number, port of load, port of discharge. It is an empty or like any other reefer unit, it will get highlighted here. So this is regarding DG. So another way of inputting weight in the DG is you go just click on some DG containers, all the details will come here. Then you go to the Dagos. Dagos will show what type of DG container it is here. So this one is class 8, UN number, this one. And if you want to input weight, you double click here. Same, will input some weight and check if it is a marine pollutant or not. Just mark this one, it will get here. Okay, let's say if one unit is having more than DG units inside, so how to add another, some maybe there are some other equipments which are of the some other class inside this container. So we can add from here. Let's say we'll use some UN number, you can check from here also, whatever class it's here. Okay, let's say it's class here, so it will the class will come here, the UN number will come here. Net weight you can add, okay, let's say 5000 I am putting, and some flash point is there, you can input here anything, and this marine pollutant if it is yes or no. So whatever you're putting here, it will get highlighted here. So this everything gets incorporated in the DG list also. I'll just save my plan and go to statistics, Dagos. This all this, you see I've just input the weight here, so all these things are coming here also. So here also double click, you can do same thing, and same thing on the plan also, you can go check this one. Okay, so this is for the DGs. Same any other thing. Okay, let's say my planner tells me, okay, this unit we have loaded is a reefer unit, so but is here it is showing a normal unit, how to mark as reefer? Same, I've highlighted this container. Okay, you check all the details, the container number is here, you mark this one as reefer. Then reefer not okay, I'm just loading, yes, this is giving alarm. Actually you see this is a very good software, it will give you like a reefer is not permitted in this position, but anyways I'm just loading for your reference. So I've just put reefer, it is, you see it is turned from yellow to green color. You go to temperature, how much temperature set point it is, you put the set point here. So same, okay, no problem. Okay, we're just loading. So set temperature. So whenever you're like you are taking out the printout of the reefer reefer list, the set point would also show in the reefer list. So same, if you remember I told you how to take the reefer list, quick search, okay, reefer, run. You see all the load column settings I told you, go to reefer settings. You see this is the set points what I have just input, -18. This was the unit I have just changed to reefer unit 7282. So if you click here, same. If your planner tells when this is an OOG container, so you can check, you can put open top, flat track, any other containers. So everything, like it's a very user friendly software. So apart from this, other things, I'll show you this quick search. There's lot of options here. I've already showed you port of load, port of discharge. Okay, let's say you want to search some container. Let's say I want to search this container. Maybe your planner tells you, okay, do have this container on board. You can, I'll just copy this container number, quick search, clear, everything is clear, serial number, just put a paste and run. You see, this is the highlighted container. Okay, it is coming here. Anything you want to check some position of the container, okay, what container is in position, I'll take 070282. You run this one, the position will come, the container will come of the highlighted. So same, also you can check from your plan how many, like 20 feeters, 40 feeters you are loading and all, what type of cargo you are loading, all this will come from the here. So this is the like very, you will be using this this bar quick search a lot of times. Other thing from the other parameters, I'll show you few other important things also. So if you go to the settings, settings, there is very important this lashing force calculation parameters. So normally this is will tell you how much, like GM, normally we are taking calculated by MacAstro, because with every GM your lashing forces will get reflected. So on every, like if your GM is high, your lashing forces will increase. So if you take given value, it will calculate lashing forces on that given value only. But if you take calculated, so on the on this calculated GM, which is your present plan, you see my GM is 1.44. So on this GM, my lashing forces, everything will be calculated. Same, your draft, whatever is calculated, it will come here. If you put some given draft, so it will calculate the lashing forces on this given draft. But always use this calculated one to be in the present condition. Same, like what wind speed you are expecting in your leg, so try to put maximum. Same, this, sorry, this one, the vessel speed, how much you will be putting, try to put maximum, your maximum vessel speed, and this wind speed also, and this roll angle also you can put for the default for the class. Apart from this, actually this is the, this is not the latest version. The latest version, there's one more tab for the routes also. So from there you can select the route, like whatever route you are doing, Asia, Africa, or you are doing this Trans-Pacific, so your lashing forces, everything will be calculated on the basis of that one. So this one will give, okay, I'll just cancel this one. Okay, if you want to check this visibility, visibility is here, so you can check your visibility. Okay, let's say now my visibility is okay. So if it is my visibility is like hindering somewhere, it will also reflect in the pan. Okay, I'll give you an example. I will go to some other, some way. Okay, let's say if I put this container here. So you see now I will get a visibility error. You can check from the here also. You see Panama visibility. Here it is coming. So same thing. You can check from this condition also visibility. You see, this is the unit. You see red color is coming here. So the position is also coming here, 081690, and the container unit is also coming here. So it's very easy to recognize, like which container is obstructing your bay. So 081690, so this is the same unit, you see 081690. Once I remove this one, okay, your error will go from the here. Okay, so here you can see your Panama visibility, how much is the your IMO visibility is 500. So at present my visibility is 391. Okay, and this if you want to see your summary, cargo, standard cargo summary, I told you before also, here you can see the overview of your cargo, you can create PDF, this is your PDF, you can export also. Same, then this from, you see your IMDG summary, which is very important. You will see your total IMDG classes here, and total this is the net weight in kg. So also if you want to see for your next port, you can click this one, your next port, how much DG cargo is discharging in the next port. So this is your giving for the discharging next port, and also giving the transit for the rest of the ports. So it is very useful. So apart from this one, this, okay, this one we are not using much. Tonnage summary is there, you can see the tonnage sheet for all the next ports, how much cargo is there, total how much weight is there. And other thing, special ports, like if you're transiting Swiss and all, you can just click here, Swiss here, all this, whatever this, mostly these things we need for Swiss transit, like how much cargo we are loading on deck, how many tiers are there. So all the information you can get from here. You can create PDF also. All the thing, everything will come here. So all the special ports you can choose from here. Let's say for Panama and all, everything, this loading port, whatever information for are required for these ports, you will get it here. Maybe okay, like by chance you get some error or something. Let's say by mistake and I've closed this tab book. Now you're worried how to get this cargo information. You see, you are not getting here. I'm clicking on the container, you're not getting any cargo summary. So you can go to layout, you can go to restore default layout. So if anything mishaps, anything happens, you see everything will come back to normal. Go to twin bay, you see now you're clicking on the cargo, everything is coming. So anything by mistake, if you close some tab and all, and you want to get to previous version, just go to this restore to default layout. Other thing is this help about this. You can get your all the details of the CCoS here. So CCoS MX3. IMDG amendment. You can see what are your latest amendment of the IMDG. So Daegu. We have the 37. This is actually not as the latest one. So this one you can check from here. So other thing, this report and all. So I just input this PDF report you will get from here for departure. Everything, all the details are given here. Like all your tanks are here, your drafts are shown here, your propeller immersion. Okay, air draft is shown here. You see, air draft will come here. Then your draft marks, everything. Your hull, this wind for the hull area. This period of rolling, all the important information. This your GZ curve, everything you will get in this report. So I'll show you one very important thing. Let's say now I have loaded 50 IMDG containers here. And my ROB container was 100 units, so total overall I have 150 IMDG units. But now I've loaded the present plan. So this thing, this my old IMDG units, which are loaded in the last port, are not will not show the net weight here. So whatever changes whatever weights I have input for the DG cargos in my last port is not showing in this plan. So same thing when I was telling you, when you like load some plan. There's always an option for merge info. Okay, same. I'll show you this EDF file I showed you before. Okay, go here. So same, I told you, if you merge info, your this previous IMDG information will get merged in this plan. But I told you sometimes it gets some error. So normally I don't use this option. So once I've loaded this plan, what you do? You can go to the pier. Pier is same like you have placed some unit on the jetty. Like let's say if I place this unit here. So this container will not get incorporated in the plan, so it will not be accounted for. So same, it is on the jetty. So once you place back on the ship, it will get accounted for. So okay, I was telling about the DG. So what you do, right click here, file, load. I'll just plan my this arrival Nansha plan. So what was my ROB plan? So it is having lot of DG what I was having before. Then you do right click here, merge info, override DG only, merge. So it will show I had previous 227 units which were having IMDG units. So all these weights have come here. Let's say now we'll check here. That goes on board. You see all the net weight from my this previous cargo have come here. Only the units which I am loading in the present port are not getting reflected here. So this is a very good option. Like whatever your changes you are making, you can always like always input your previous IMDG weights and all in the present plan. So these things from P, I don't want this one clear. I'll just put yes. So just save again. Only now job you have to do is just input the weights of the present whatever cargo we are loading in the Nansha. Okay, let's say we put here, it will get reflected here. Same, this IMDG list you can use, just create PDF. Okay, so this all the IMDG. Maybe if the your planner is asking some other informations regarding he doesn't wait, it does not wait this net weight and all. I showed you before this settings, net weight. Okay, if he doesn't want this DG, IMDG weight and all, everything you can just click anything, you can just remove from here. Okay, so this was regarding the DG units. So okay, other important thing is like maybe I want to see, maybe next port I don't have any loading and only discharging here. Okay, let's say my next port is okay Singapore. I'll go to port of discharge, Singapore. Total cargo here. I just want to check what will be my draft after I discharge this cargo for the next port Singapore. So what you do, you go to pre-select here. So close. So you see all the units which are getting discharged on my next port are getting highlighted. So what I'll do, I'll just shift this container, sir. If you shift all these units, for 367 were units for my discharging Singapore. They have come to pier, means on the jetty. So I can check, okay, what will be my drafts in Singapore after like discharging, as there's no loading and all. So you can just put done here, and if you want, you can remove the cargo here. Okay, now this one will be my plan after discharging from Singapore. So this is also very important point. Okay, other thing, like I was telling you, maybe your drafts, sir, most of the navigators, your drafts will not match what are with your visual drafts, sir. So what is the best thing we can do, So let's say you have loaded cargo in this port, and checked your visual draft. And my visual drafts were, let's say, around 13.4, which is like way higher than this one. So in this case, what you can go to this dead load calculation. So you can just put your draft marks. Okay, let's say I check my draft marks at perpendicular. So they came around 13.6. So I'll just put all the information here. 13.6. Okay, amidship also 13.6. Okay, this one were at my this draft set draft marks. So okay, let's say my density 1.025. Enter. Okay, so you see now you can just report. You see, so this one will be your draft marks at perpendicular, and your this visual draft marks what you have seen. So this will be the displacement, and your dead load will come here. Dead load, and your LCG, TCG, and VCG will appear here. So all these things, so you can go to your dead load page here. You can put the same weight, LCG, VCG, TCG, all this everything here. So after inputting these things, your this loadicated drafts will get in line with the visual drafts. So normally, like this is a good practice. So how you will come to know your dead load also, and there will not be any discrepancy from your visual draft and your calculated drafts. From this, I told you strength. You can see your bending moment, shearing forces. Okay, this one I already explained you before how to check this one. Okay, let's say maybe your torsional moments are increasing somewhere. Okay, let's say this normally happens because of fuel oil. Let's say I've taken fuel oil almost 1,000 meter cubes here. And you say your torsional moments, okay, it's not increasing much. Maybe let's say it's going over 100 here, or your okay, let's reduce this one to 10. You see your torsional moments will keep on increasing. I'm just giving an example, So it is getting 74, list is getting so now you want to reduce your torsional moment, So in this case you go to stability, strength. You see your torsional moment, So here it will get asterisk marker, which is the like maximum your torsional moments are coming here. This is, you see 74 are coming near this frame number 79. So the frame number starts from aft. You can go to this 79, 79. That is coming from bay around 1921. So I will go to my tanks. So I know my ballast tanks which are near this 1921. So let's say if I take some water here. Okay, I'll take around full almost. You see, my torsion movements are automatically reduced. So always you can check your torsional, whatever bending moment sharing force is coming here, what is the maximum, accordingly you check the frame number, then accordingly you can adjust your tanks to clear these moments and also to reduce them.